Talking of TCS, it will kickstart the earnings season today, post market hours. Like Lata said, Rima, perhaps we'll have a long day, but Rima, first tell us what to expect.
Well, this time around, the company is also going to be considering a buyback, so that will be crucially watched. When it comes to the numbers, we're expecting a very strong quarter for TCS as well as the rest of the IT pack. Demand trends have been strong, the order booking has been healthy, and supply side constraints have normalized. If you remember, in quarter one, TCS had reported a sharp revenue drop of 7%. There was a drop in margins by 150 basis points, and this quarter is expected to be a recovery quarter. So revenues will go up by 4.5% in dollar terms. In constant currency terms, it should be a sequential improvement of 3%, and margins too, according to our poll, should be higher by 130 basis points on a quarter-on-quarter basis. So expect good growth in revenues and margins on a quarter-on-quarter basis. Profits will show a decline, but that's on account of the exceptional provisional loss that the company indicated that they will be taking in the Epic case. The question is, does the company have the confidence to up the guidance? If you remember last time, they said that in the March quarter, we will see flattish constant currency revenue. Can they do better than that? And when it comes to invest management commentary, I think the key is going to be the strength of this recovery. You know, are we in a strong upcycle which can result in growth being strong for FY22, FY23? So commentary surrounding that, which you can gauge via the deal wins, the order booking, deal conversion pipeline, all that will be crucially watched. Now, while the numbers are expected to be good, bear in mind that TCS has outperformed the markets per se. It's at a fresh life high. It's rallied close to about 35. It's rallied close to about, you know, significantly from the start of the year, but it has underperformed its peers like in Infosys. Back to you.
All right, thanks a lot for that. Yes, in fact, TCS, if you look at it for the year, is up almost about 27%. Apurva Prasad, who tracks the space very closely, joins in. Apurva, you know, the stock has rallied quite a bit. What is it in the numbers that will cause an incremental up move in the stock?
So I think what they really guide out for the second half, I think that will be very critical. So while we're expecting in dollar terms about 3.5% type of a Q1Q growth and a margin expansion of over 100 basis points sequentially, I think a lot of benefits is coming from the supply side factors which get reversed. A lot of temporary pricing and volume cuts which happened March, April, that gets reversed. So that also has a role to play in the third quarter number. So I think really the outlook that they provide will be critical. One, two, the overall deal TCV, which we expect to be a very strong number going by the large deals that they've reported. So I think this quarter should be another very strong large deal. So I think their commentary around that, commentary around some of the core verticals such as BFSI, which has been a relative outperformer among the other verticals. I think some of these areas would be quite critical. But I think they will be a very big beneficiary of the overall broader sectoral tailwinds that you're seeing. The fact that cloud transformation timelines are getting compressed in a very big way. Enterprise budgets priority is taken up on the tech budget side. So I think some of those two aspects are factors which will aid TCS in a very big way.
Okay, but Apurva, good morning. How much of this is in the price now with the kind of rally that we have seen, and it's almost trading at all-time high valuations now?
Sure. Yeah, it is. It is. I mean, it is pretty much above the two standard deviation valuations. But that's pretty much the case for the sector. If you look across the board, that's really the case. So I think this kind of valuation is sustainable. I think the higher valuation is sustainable, premised on the fact that there is longevity of high growth period. And I think that plays a big role in this. And the fact that there is still room for payouts to go up overall. So while they are on the upper end in terms of the sector payouts, but I think there is still scope for a lot of other companies to increase that. And I think these are value accretive factors. So the fact that you can grow for a significantly higher level than what you've grown in the past 4 to 5 years, I think that will merit the fact that valuations can remain elevated. But if I have to take a one-year call, we are more positive on names like Infosys and HCL Tech.
Okay, yeah, you're right about valuations. Anuj and Apurva, it's 28.5 times FY22. Their normal mean, I believe, is 24. Okay, since we have you with us, Apurva, this Trump announcement of tighter H-1B wages, higher H-1B wages and tighter rules, any negatives for any stock?
Not really, Lata. I think the overall dependency on H-1Bs has reduced drastically over the past 3 to 4 years. So I don't think it's going to really be material. The kind of investments that they've been doing around local hiring, I think that negates a lot of impact that, you know, what it brings. There have been a lot of executive orders that have come over the past few years, which have been very restrictive. And I think the companies have mostly managed through that. So I would not really see too much of an impact, whether it is in case of increase of minimum wage as well as more restrictions, because these are new filings anyways that we're talking about and not new. So I would not think it's a negative at all.
Okay, thank you very much, Apurva, and we will touch base with you after the results are out post-market hours. Thank you very much for joining us with your thoughts.